Hello dear learners, I am Dr. Akhilesh Singh. I am assistant professor and program coordinator in Department of Tourism, Uttarakhand Open University, Haldwani. Today we will understand about the meaning, features and types of tourism product. Firstly, we will understand about the meaning of product. A product is any good, services or idea that can be offered to a person in the market, and that product should have the ability to satisfy the needs and wants of a person who has purchased it. We can divide a product into two parts, tangible products and intangible products. Intangible products are also known as service products. Now we will understand about the meaning of services. Here we will understand the definition of service given by Philip Kotler. A service is any act or performance that one party can offer to another that is essentially intangible and does not result in the ownership of anything. Its production may or may not be tied to a physical product. It means a service product is different from any tangible product because we cannot keep the service product with us. We can only experience, we can enjoy it, and we can share our experience with others, and we cannot take this product with us. But in case of tangible product, for example pen, mobile phones, which are tangible in nature, we can keep them with us. Now we will understand about the meaning of tourism product. A tourism product is the sum of the physical and psychological experience got by tourist during their traveling to the destination. A tourism product is service in nature, and it is also known as intangible product. But actually a tourism product include some physical products, some tangible products and intangible products. For example, when a person travels to any destination in order to purchase anything, for example, if a tourist travels to international trade fair, which every year helds in October or November month in Delhi. A person, if he travels to there and he purchases any product from international trade fair, then it means that product is tangible in nature. But when a person experiences the services of guide, services of taxi driver, services of air hostess, then it means these products are intangible in nature. So every tourism product has tangible and intangible both products. Now we will understand about the features of tourism product. There are so many features of tourism product. Intangibility, inseparability, perishability, variability or heterogeneity, absence of ownership, manufactured by many producers, then highly unstable demand or seasonal product. Now we will understand each feature of tourism product in descriptive way. The first important feature of tourism product is intangibility. Intangibility means the products which cannot be touched or cannot be taken by the person with him. In intangibility, we can include guide services, air hostess services, doctor services, teacher services. Because all these persons don't provide anything which are tangible in nature. They only share their experience, their thought, their knowledge with their customers. For example, a person who is a guide, if he works in Agra, then he will provide the historical features and about the cultural features of Taj Mahal, Red Fort, Fatehpur Sikri to the tourist who is ready to take his services. He doesn't provide anything which is tangible in nature. Similar way, an air hostess also doesn't provide anything tangible product. She only provides her services. She only takes cares to the airline passengers. Similar way, doctor also doesn't provide anything tangible product. He only prescribes some medicines to which you can purchase it from his doctors on medical shop or from any other shop. Similar way, a teacher services also intangible in nature, because a teacher also shares his experiences, thoughts, and knowledge about any topic. He also doesn't provide anything intangible. Now, the second important feature of tourism product is inseparability. It means we cannot separate the tourism product and its service provider. For example, a guide who has to describe about the Taj Mahal and its historical features, then a guide should present at the destination. If a guide is not available at the destination, then it means he is not providing his services. A taxi driver who has to take to a passenger from any hotel to airport, then it means he has to go to the hotel to take that tourist. If he doesn't go to the destination, then it means he is not providing his services to his customers. It means he should present at the destination where he has to provide his services to the customer. Then important feature of tourism product is perishability. Perishability means we cannot store the tourism products in any warehouse and we cannot use that product in future. If we don't use any product on the same day, then we will lose its value. For example, if some seats of airlines or some rooms of hotels are unbooked on any particular day, then on the same day we will not get its loss. But in case of tangible products, we can store our products in the warehouse and we can resell it on any other day. For example, pen, mobile phones, car, we can store all these tangible products in the warehouse and we can resell them when we get their demand. But in intangible products, if we lose any demand on any particular day, then we will never get its recovery in future. Then variability or heterogeneity. As we know that tourism products are manufactured by many persons and its services are provided by many suppliers, many persons. So a person's behavior is also different from any other person. For example, if we meet any guide to any destination, then his services, his behavior will be different from any other person who had provided us his guide services at any other destination. We can take example of a similar person, an air hostess who had provided us her services in the morning. Her behavior, her way of providing services will be different in the evening time, because we cannot separate the same kind of services, same kind of behavior from a same person or from other person in a similar way. Every person has different kind of behavior, every person different kind of situation. So he will provide his services according to his intellectuality, according to his mentality. Now, absence of ownership. As we know that when we purchase any tangible product, then we become the owner of that product. If I purchase any mobile phone, then I will become the owner of that mobile phone. But when we purchase any tourism product, then we cannot claim that now we are the owner of that product. For example, when we hire any taxi, then we can only take its services from departure destination to arrival destination. After reaching at the destination, we have to leave that taxi. In the similar way, if we hire any hotel room, then after taking its services, when checkout time comes, then we have to leave the hotel room. We cannot claim that now we are the owner of that taxi or that hotel room or complete property of the hotel. Now, manufactured by many producers. As we know that tourism products are assembled by including so many tourism products, and all these tourism products are manufactured by so many producers. As we know that we include airline company services, hotel rooms, railway services, transport company services, insurance company services, bank services, and after purchasing all components from these service providers, a travel agency makes complete tour package. Then last, highly unstable डिमांड और सीजनल प्रोडक्ट. एज वी नो दैट टूरिज्म प्रोडक्ट डिपेंड्स अपॉन सो मैनी फैक्टर, इट्स डिमांड इज अफेक्टेड बाई सो मैनी फैक्टर्स. एज वी नो दैट वी कैन नॉट प्रिडिक्ट द डिमांड ऑफ द टूरिज्म प्रोडक्ट इन फ्यूचर. इन दिसंबर, इन द अर्लियर डेज ऑफ दिसंबर 2019, nobody knew that any COVID-19 virus will come in the world, which will affect or which will destroy to the tourism industry of world. And tourism industry is not only affected by the such kind of viruses, but it is also affected by riots, floods, wars, earthquakes, and time to time we have seen its effect on the tourism industry. So these kind of challenges always affect to the tourism industry and the people who are working in this sector. So the service providers always should be aware about the such kind of situations and always try to cover these kind of situations, and they should be also familiar and they should be also experienced how to tackle with such kind of situations. So here in this video we had discussed about different kinds of tourism product, its meaning and its different features. In our next video we will understand about any other topic. Thank you so much, dear learners.